Hello, this is a project that I've started a few days ago. It's regarding a 3D wall art and can be done by absolutely anything, anybody with any skills. So just a little bit patience and a little bit willingness to do this type of job if you like it. So that is going to improve space that probably you don't have. Something to hang on the wall, or you don't like to the way that looks, so you can improve it greatly. So this can be done in an absolutely very, very easy way. So definitely I'll be more than happy to show you exactly how can be done. So let's get a close-up look. And you'll just try to use your own imagination and do whatever you like because absolutely it's the easiest way to have a 3D wall art on any of the walls that you have in the house, wherever you wish to have it. So let's continue and show you the way that I made the leaf. First of all, I made like a template that is a normal piece of paper, or you can use a harder kind of surface that is like a cardboard or anything else. So I chose the pattern. In this case, I'm going to just use all-purposes drywall compound. And I'm going to get a big block of this one and just put it on my surface here. And I'm trying to get a thickness around an eighth of an inch or probably half of a centimeter to make sure that the 3D effect is going to look nice and is going to give me exactly the look that I'm looking for. So I will try to just finish this block here. And on top of it, I'm going to use another piece of plastic. This is a like shopping bag. And I will just gently push it down, trying to reach the thickness that I'm looking for. You can use a roller or a bottle or anything else, whatever makes you feel much more comfortable. Or you can just use a tool and try to reach, as I said, the thickness that you need, and also the surface that needs to be covered. So I'm going to just make sure that I have enough everywhere. And in this case, I'm going to remove the first layer of the plastic bag. I'll try to smooth a little bit the surface to make it to look nice as much as I wish. And after that, I'm going just to place the template on top. Now again, the thickness, it's exactly the way that you wish, as much as you wish. It doesn't matter here, it's up to you. So I'm going to just place the template on top. I will tap it just gently all the way around to make sure that has the contact with the compound. And gently I'm going to carve all the way around. And for this, I'm using to recover all the compound that I don't need it. I'm going to place it back here on this one and put it back in a pail, whatever I don't need. So I will try to carve everything everywhere, making sure that I'm using all the details, not to get rid of them. And you will just try to work, not in a fast way, but firmly way, kind of. After I finished all the way around, I'll try to go to smooth the surface, to make it look nice, of course, and have the control over the shape. And I'll try gently to remove the insides of the leaf to make sure that is going to appear on the wall like a very natural way. The look is not going to be, it's not missing any details. Okay. Here I have already a dried leaf. That is the way that is going to look at the end. So it's already, looks very nice already. And I'm going to show you how can I attach it to the wall. So for this I'm using, this is a kind of, you know, a silicone that is the cheapest one. You don't have to put too money in this project. So I'm using this one. I'm going to attach a little bit of this silicone on the back of the leaf. And I'm trying to spread it a little bit, just a little bit, because you need a surface to make a contact with the wall. And just spread it here and there to make sure that all the sides of the leaf are kind of touching the wall and is going to stick to the wall actually. And here I have more. Okay, and now I'm going to just place the leaf the way that I wish to look on the wall. And of course I'm going to look to show a little bit, like a little bit more. I will leave it at the, like a center point, to make sure that it's going to stay firmly on in its place. And it's going to be, let's say, like I will love it to be like so. I'm going just gently press it, and the silicone is going to do its magic and is going to stick the leaf to the wall. Now, to give more nature look for the entire project, I'm going to use again this silicone to try to make some vines that are going to connect the leaves together. Like, let's just start from this side, and I'm going just in a very fine way to just push it. Stop there, and I will come later to make any more details. And I'm going to come here again, and the whole purpose of this gun now is to give that feeling of the leaf, the veins that are with the leaf. You can come again over, doesn't matter. If it's not going to work fine from the first time, you can just adjust a little bit further later. Yeah, and of course you can continue to make my to improve the design even more if you wish. You can go with kind of vines that are growing in this way. Again, you can just come later and fix the details, or even from here give it as much as you can, like the natural look of the plant that you wish to represent here. So you can go like so, and I'm going to continue the design here, and I'm going to show you in a minute the end of it. And to just work here and there a little bit more. So I will be back immediately. This is the final look of my project. So I will just give you a tour and you will see now the entire work. And here I try to build up the same pattern on this kind of wall, very, very narrow hole, narrow wall. And I try to get the continuity from the main kind of bush flower that I've started on the main wall. So here you have, it's like entire plant to cover the bathroom wall. And here I have created kind of a flower using the same procedure. And I try to make it like a focal point for this wall. And all the vines are going to bring all the leaves together. And I can tell you that I'm very pleased with the final look of my project. Definitely this was too boring, like the walls were absolutely showing nothing or saying nothing. And that was a very great space to try to apply my imagination and see what I can do from this space. So this is a project that I'm very pleased with. And if you have questions or if you need more information regarding this project, gladly I will share it with you. I hope that was a good reason for you to start a project in your house. I wish you good luck and thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you. Goodbye.